now you be checking your ticket.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
So when I say somebody about to get a blessing, you need to check yourself.
Yes.
Make sure you're in the right attitude.
Hallelujah.
Make sure you're in the right frame of mind.
Yes.
To receive what God has for you.
Yes.
See, now if you don't have a ticket, you ain't gonna be looking around. You ain't got no way of winning anything, right? Amen. But if we're on the same page and you checking in this lottery of the Holy Ghost. Glory. I know some of y'all don't like that. But glory to God. I'm trying to help somebody.
All right now.
Hallelujah. Somebody's going to get blessed this morning. Amen. I'm coming out of the translation, God's Word. And it says in that 13th verse, but the blood on your houses will be a sign for your protection. When I see the blood, I will pass over you. Nothing. Somebody said nothing.
Nothing.
Yeah, I like that part. Nothing will touch or destroy you when I strike Egypt. Look at somebody and say, I thank God
for the blood.
Look at somebody that said, I thank God
for the blood.
Amen. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Father, in the name of Jesus, holy Lamb of God, thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise you right now, God. We welcome your Holy Spirit in this place. Holy Spirit, take control. Holy Spirit, rule and reign. Saturate this place with your Spirit, Lord. Send us a fresh anointing that we may stand and preach and proclaim your word. You said, if I be lifted up, to draw all men unto you, we lift you up now. We give you all the praise. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Thank God for the blood. Blood is that red liquid that circulates throughout the veins and the arteries, carrying oxygen, because without it, cells cannot live.
All right.
The blood also carries food, which enables growth and the repair of cells. The blood, as well as other vital processes such as hormones, which are messengers that regulate activities in various organs. While protein thickens the blood, but as we take a closer look at the blood under the microscopic lenses, it reveals that this liquid of life is made of cells that is suspended into strong colored liquids. And these cells include red ones that carry oxygen throughout the body cells while removing carbon dioxide from the body. And then there are the white blood cells, which serve as a defense against bacteria by squeezing through the capillary wall, reaching the places of infection where germs are destroyed. And then there is plasma, which is made up of 92% water and 7% protein and 1% minerals, the blood. then there are vitamins, sugar, enzymes, and platelets. These are the colorless cells which controls the bleeding and forms blood clots, which aids in the healing of wounds. When we look at what all the blood does for the body, its chemistry does bring life. As seen in the book of Exodus, because this episode in the text takes place right before the Lord God Almighty sends that last terrible plague. You remember the plague of death of the firstborn, and when God told Moses to go down to Egypt and tell Pharaoh to let my people go, that they may be able to go and celebrate a feast unto me in the wilderness. And to this divine command, Pharaoh answered, saying, "Who is the Lord that I should hearken unto his voice?" The record reveals that when God struck Egypt with all those terrible plagues, y'all do remember the plagues, right? When God turned the water of the Nile River into blood, and then he sent the plague of frogs and the plagues of lice and the plagues of flies and the livestock was diseased, and then there was the plague of balls, the plague of hailstorms and the plagues of locusts, and then there was the plague of darkness. And even in the midst of all of these catastrophes, the Bible says Pharaoh's heart was still hard. But that's what my brothers and sisters, the God of the universe says to Moses in this 11th chapter. Notice he said, when the Lord said to Moses, he said, "Yet I will bring one more upon Pharaoh and upon Egypt, and after that he will let you go hence, and he shall let you go. He shall surely thrust you out all the other." In other words, when I get through with Pharaoh, he'll be glad to let you go. Can I get a witness here? God also tells Moses to go tell the children of Israel to get out an unblemished male lamb that was 1 year old and tell them to slay the lamb, kill it, and take the blood and put the blood over the doorposts across the entrance of the house and tell them. You see, he left specific instructions. That's what I like about the word of God. It leaves no room for guessing. Amen. The word is straightforward. It says, tell them to roast the lamb. Eat it with bitter herbs and unleavened bread. And the bitter herbs is to remind them of their bitter experience in Egypt. Tell them the unleavened bread is without yeast because it wasn't time for the bread to rise. And well, the leaven was a symbol of impurity to the Jews because yeast is the image of sin. And during this Passover, they were to eat unleavened bread, remove all the leavened bread from their dwelling. And God told Moses to tell them to eat and get in a hurry because he was getting ready to send this last plague. But this is the Lord's Passover. And God tells Moses, when I see the blood, when I see the blood, not your good works, when I see the blood, not your fame or fortune, when I see the blood, not your popularity or your position, when I see the blood, I will pass over you. Thank God for the blood.
Amen. Amen.
Oh yes, he says, and when I see the blood, no plague will fall upon you, because even in the power of God, we can see the power of God in the blood. Because you see, my brothers and sisters, the blood confirms our identity as a ransomed soul bought before the foe. And the reason why the blood of the Lamb of Passover in Egypt was a mark that identifies the people of God, because the Christian selfhood is not determined by the amount of earthly possessions that you accumulate, but understanding. You are not a Christian because of how you dress.
Amen.
You are not a Christian because of what church you attend and how you are baptized. You are not a Christian because you, amen, drive a certain car or live in a certain neighborhood or hold a certain job, but you are a Christian by the grace of God.
Amen.
You were bought with the sinless blood of the Lamb. That's why Paul tells us in the first letter to the church at Corinth, he says that you were bought with a price. You were bought to glorify God in your body and in your spirit. Amen. My brothers and sisters, can I take my time and tell you what I'm talking about? You see, God blessed me to buy suits, and he wants to make me look good. And he blesses you to buy clothes. What you're talking about, you see, if you're going to be a child of God, you can't be a secret Christian. You gotta have it on the doorpost. You gotta let folks know I'm covered by the blood. I wonder if anybody here today not ashamed to say, I'm covered by the blood. You see, he said, he called them, he said, he didn't say, put it over your bedpost, or put it over your kitchen, or put it over. Judgment of God, which is to come, and the Bible says judgment will begin at the house of God. You see, my brothers and sisters, when we were younger, we used to play a game called hide and seek. That was before PlayStation and all those Xbox games. We didn't have all that fancy stuff that you got today. We had to go outside and make up games. You said safe. touch you. Nothing shall destroy you. Our you not say it. If you doubt it, don't worry. Hallelujah. If death should catch you, and you haven't made it to the tree, you're not saved. Hallelujah. One of these days, death won't tag you. Between death and you tag, well, you're not saved now. Hallelujah. For me to live is Christ. For me to die is the gain. Aren't you glad it was the blood of Christ?